Greetings, Leon Nation of the New Earth Revelation. It is time, heart-conscious family of the true collective of holy matrimony, to rise up in sacred solidarity as a collective conscious co-creators of enlightened awareness, to transmit your highest light, your highest love, your highest codes out into the field, into the infinite energy of the rainbow tribes. Happy quantum leap day, the day out of time, the zero point energy, the space in between the sounds. Today's first transmission from Lisa Transcendence Brown, massive 22222222, power up and new earth codes, the 222 energies coming in fully now. Your light is what makes a difference here. Quantum leap month, year underway now. Your light is what makes the difference. The February gateway is complete. Now we quantum leap into March's powerful passageway. Aloha, Soul Star Light family. We've been so busy, and I'm not as visible when I'm back to back, connecting, collaborating with so many, and completing various quantum timeline shifting cycles through pure presence as fast as we complete these now. Pure presence and functioning from zero point fully allows us to do all with great ease, simplicity, and through divine sacred union and harmony from deep within. It's a part of the full embodiment and living our highest in every way. In order to keep up with the rate at which we accomplish all quantum, total focus of our consciousness energy is required. Therefore, how we function changes all along the way is relative to the dimension density we physically occupy and the multitude of current service roles we fulfill. I am always so very deeply connected and working with you all constantly, which is beyond beautiful within itself. I'll be sharing more soon as we've been busy accomplishing daily all that's highest aligned for fulfilling much higher service roles for all of humanity. Beautiful collaborations, sharings, creations, and experiences with pure excitement, joy, and various levels of sacred union with star family, soul family, light family, who are also working in service through higher service role fulfillment and as unity, purity, consciousness. For now, our heartfelt expression of immense gratitude, appreciation, and love for you all. Through the years, we've all come to understand the immensity of dedication and commitment required by each one of us doing this fully. The return is living heaven because we all consciously chose what we are willing to live, accept, and allow, and no longer compromise on a soul level in any way, which is part of the immense 22222222 power-up codes that flooded through all of February, further supporting all in achieving with greater ease where this is each one's priority and where excuses, disempowerment are released fully. The last few weeks have been pure power codes, focused on no more compromises, soul, star, light, love beings in any way. Each will have to consciously choose to utilize, apply, and live these. Otherwise, the codes for all vibrationally aligning for all new realities continue to lay dormant within. Many of you have felt this come from within you, the immensity of this power, in choosing, aligning, and holding your new fully. These are amazing and also garner massive collective individual shifts, which correlate to entire inner reality changes, shifts moving all further through these quantum evolutionary processes of our evolving planet, evolving DNA, and the formation of our new Earth family societies, as well as creating, building, forming, and living by all new Earth templates and codes, which supports humanity's transition processes being experienced with greater ease. This is able to occur where all are truly open, ready, and fully embracing this. Unity consciousness is a state of being, a presence, and a way of living. As more live this fully, we are able to unite, come together, work and live together cohesively, and accomplish that which seemed impossible by the human aspect before. Everything is possible, yet only for those all who are truly open, deeply connected and holding their own highest will, be able to achieve this with great ease because of how we each mentally dictate linearity, density, complicates, gets in the way. So it's each one's personal journey to clear this density programming, fixed, linear, limiting mentalities, conditioning beliefs held deep within and choose to shift to much higher timelines, realities for all actually living here. Keep anchoring, integrating, and living these magnificent New Earth codes fully and holding the highest to support, uplift, inspire, and anchor more through your own physical light body field and entire reality. As each are able to do this, then this creates cohesion as the unified field of consciousness for all to enjoy, live, breathe, experience, and expand exponentially to touch the hearts, lives of all others here too. I have new articles coming out very soon, as well as returning to more public interviews, discussions, talks, live events, in addition to various community gatherings too. As our New Earth networking system continues to unite, expand, and grow, we are able to accomplish and complete various launches of new, more humanitarian projects, which create more opportunity for all, as well as provide various new levels of support and services to further guide, assist, all fully embracing on every level. So stay tuned in every way, and we look forward to connecting, uniting, and accomplishing much more together as the magnificent soul starlight family that we all are here to usher in more heaven for all to enjoy and live fully, share fully, and incorporate fully in their own lives. I love and deeply appreciate each and every one of you. Live your life, live your love fully. Your beautiful light makes a huge difference on a multidimensional level for all. Your light is as powerful as love. We are all here to usher in all new. We are all the change. And what makes a difference here through living our highest states of consciousness? Massive inner shifts mean massive reality shifts, mean all new realizations that empower each to consciously choose and shift entire realities from deep inside and hold the highest vibrational alignment by being pure source consciousness, light, and fully conscious of all that you vibrationally create, allow, and call forth as actual experiences here. Live your light. Shine your absolute brightest as love. Show all how this is done. Be the example. And create a space where all feel safe doing the same, as this will change all to move beyond their boxes, limits, and safety protection mechanisms held deep within, and we each can hold the highest, softest, most beautiful, so that others are ready, open, and excited to join us as pure love to building your light from inside. As a beyond important part of this experience, so that you can hold your own, your new realities in place. Whether you pull away or come together as a group is just as important, yet different light body phases do this differently due to each one's current body field tuning processes and fulfillment of various service roles here. Being kind, loving, respectful to your own physical light body and what it speaks to you, tells you is important, ask for you to surrender to, honor, support, is beyond important for this entire process, as your human aspect will want to override, interfere, go to fear, try to control or completely ignore these things due to deep-seated programming and separation held deep within. Your physical light body doesn't conform to the old ways, anything you once thought you knew or understood. It doesn't work like your carbon-based human body did either, not 1 ounce. The amount of full surrender and deep sacred connection, respect we have to hold and is beyond immense and will challenge every bit of your ego aspect. This is how all works, is it's you that must break down all of this old programming that you didn't even know was there and transcend all through complete purity, love, and a unified state from deep within. Anchoring New Earth codes with your physical body won't look like anything you think. It's actually quite the opposite of this. Holding pure light requires certain things from you, and conforming, reverting to fear is the old way of doing all of this. There are easier ways, yet your own heart mind must be completely wide open, and your willingness, openness, and dedication priorities must completely shift so that your ego aspect is not allowed to get in the way, which is entirely up to you. Shift completely inside and everything will shift for you. Remember, we are all star family, light family, and soul family in body form here. We hold each other to our highest and treat each other with the utmost respect while consciously choosing our own realities and living these fully through beautiful, sacred connection and union from deep, deep, deep within. From Lisa Transcendence Brown, awakeningtoremembering.com. And from Trevor McGrath, how 528 hertz manifests 144,000 in the brain and heart. The heart and brain are both 73% water. There's the 73 energies manifesting through the physical. Humidity slightly alters the speed of sound. The average healthy body temperature is 98.6 degrees Fahrenheit. At 98.6 degrees Fahrenheit with 73% humidity, the speed of sound travels inside of the body at 355.68 meters per second. This makes a 528 hertz wavelength in the body 0.6736 meters. If you divide that by the rate of gravitation acceleration, 9.81 meters per second, you get octaves of 144,000.16179 hertz. Notice something? The whole number is 144,000, and the decimal unmanifest number is phi, the golden ratio, gravity, golden spiral, and 144,000 being the number of ascension. The spiral staircase comes to mind, Jacob's ladder. The DNA, which is 528 hertz, heals. Once again, this is all a result of 528 hertz resonating in the brain, and the heart's 73% humidity at the average 98.6 degrees Fahrenheit. This is how 528 hertz manifests the frequency of 144,000 within the brain and heart. 144,000.6179, which is 144,000 within the 99.99988% accuracy. It's nothing short of a miracle that the heart and brain have just the right humidity to cause this math to work out with such accuracy within them relative to the speed of sound at body temperature. Note that 528 hertz music has been proven to cause more oxytocin, love hormone, to release in the body. Love is the key to ascension and DNA healing. From Trevor McGrath, from Elizabeth Peru, February 29, the day out of time, beloved ones. Now that we're halfway through Mercury retrograde and people on cue with this predicted planetary shift are globally starting to take action this weekend, it's also the highly spiritual day that comes around once every 4 years. This Saturday offers huge potential to enhance your sense of trust. Were you born on February 29th? Souls born on this day are mystery keepers, highly telepathic and psychic. The stars are aligned. Have you ever used this expression? And if so, did everyone know what you mean? February 29 has such an expansive, high vibration quality to it. It's like New Year's Day. Expand into it. And consider that when you use the word cosmic to describe life, the universe, something miraculous has just happened to you. That is, it was cosmic. Know that you're using a simple language that everyone understands. Going beyond spiritual and religious connotation, cosmic is a word and energy that most people just get and are okay with. And that's because it unites, and that's soul truth. From ElizabethPeru.com. From Christina Papagiorgio, Leap Day, 29 February 2020, 2222, a quantum leap for humanity. From midnight to 12 noon, perfecting magical planetary manifestation, liberating divine will. 29-2-2020 equal 11-2-22 equal 2-2-2-2 equal 8. 29, spiritual initiation, trial strength. 11, portal, doorway, polarity. 2, partnership, cooperation. 22, master builder, architect of peace. 4, angelic, earth, form, foundation. 8, infinity, abundance, flow. Wow, what a lineup of codes today. February is ending with a bang. We are completing the formation of the solid foundation we have been building for Terra Nova, constructed of peace, joy, equality, unity, compassion, and abundance. Today we are walking through divine doors, a portal floating through no time, holding us in suspension, preparing for the leap of faith to reach our divinely guided destination. Heaven has arrived on earth. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Today is very unique and a special day as it is a leap day, a day inserted into the Gregorian calendar to correct the anomalies of losing time over a four-year cycle because the Earth does not orbit the Sun in precisely 365 days. It actually takes 365.2421 days. So today is a balancing of correcting day for the calendar to catch up to the solar cycles, a day to literally balance the books. February was chosen as a month to have the leap day as it is the only month without 30 or 31 days. It has long been suggested that February only has 28 days due to the jealousy of Roman emperors. According to the theory, the second month of the year had 30 days before the reign of Roman Emperor Augustus. So although the Gregorian artificial time calendar has a mismatch of 12 irregular months, the natural time 13 moon calendar has 13 months of 28 days, with one D-O-O-T, day out of time, to make up 365 days. However, even with the 13 moon calendar, an extra leap day has been inserted to align the moon cycles with the solar cycles. So in essence, today's surreal energies are that of alignment, as the moon, feminine, cycles catches up and aligns with the sun, masculine cycle, which is hugely symbolic as we are attaining the optimum state of equilibrium of our divine feminine masculine selves, the attainment of great harmony and inner bliss. Today is the bridge that brings us out of the illusion of false matrix time, which the blue monkey is exposing, and into the purity of the divine creation. The natural time and harmonic matrix aligns us with the spirit through the present moment time, consequently liberating divine will and divine plan for planet Earth. So tune into the energies of this magical day and let the blue monkey take you by the hand and pull back the veils of the old false control mind matrix, filling your heart with joy and laughter as you play with your kin folk. Then through this light-heartedness, let your golden chalice overflow with unconditional love and sustenance from our divine creator, awakening your divine mind and illuminating your remembrance of source and all that is. I am that I am, and so it is. Today's energies are similar to that of the day out of time. They are very dreamlike and illusory. It occupies no time, the space between realities and dimensions where time does not exist. I was told that on this rainbow bridging day, humanity is leaping ahead in humongous quantum leaps and bounds. Divine blessings for humanity's giant leap on this historic, monumental, evolutionary day. P.S. No question needed today, just pure, bliss-filled presence. In Lakek Alakin, Christina White, Magnetic World Bridger, Kin 66. And from Tortuga1320.com, 0.0, Hunabku, 29 February, Leap Year Day. What is the 0.0 Hunabku? It is the name given to the Gregorian leap year day of 29 February in the 13 moons dream spell count, which is not taken into account. Consequently, this leap day doesn't have a kin nor a place inside the calendar of the 13 moons, but it is instead accounted as 0.0 Hunabku. This day constitutes a disruption of the 260-day dream spell Dzogchen count and the 1328 calendar system of 365 days. The 00 Hunabku day is thus considered as another day out of time. Therefore, it relates to the power of timelessness. The 00 Hunabku normally occurs between day 22 and day 23 of the eighth moon of integrity, and between the seals of the blue monkey and the yellow human. In the parallel 1328 count of the Telectonon, the 00 Hunabku occurs between the unit 22, which marks the completion of the Warrior Cube, and the Unit 23, which marks the lovers' reunion of Pakal Votan and Balonik, the bridging of heaven and earth, the leap day, and the 00 Hunabku. In the Gregorian calendar, a leap year generally occurs every 4 years when the calendar has 366 days instead of 365, and consequently the month of February has 29 days instead of its normal 28 days. This extra day on 29 February is called a leap day, and it corrects the Gregorian calendar's accumulative error with respect to the solar year. In the calendar system of the 13 moons dream spell, the 00 Hunabku adjustment on leap day was implemented by Jose R. Willis in order to keep the 52-year cycle of harmonization between the 13 moon calendar of 365 days and the 1320 dream spell Dzulkin of 260 days. For example, every 52 years was returned to our kin of birth on the exact day of our birth, which means the completion of our personal dream spell castle of 52 years. Four cycles of 13 years each equal 52. In the book of 13 Moons in Motion, Jose and Lloydine R. Willis define the 52-year harmonization as the galactic solar return cycle, precise synchronization of 52 solar lunar years with 73 galactic spins, 13 harmonic returns and 4 galactic returns, 18,980 kin. However, the disruption of the counts on a leap day constitutes one of the main criticisms of the 13 moons. After discrediting the validity of the Gregorian calendar, the 13 moons still syncs with it on February 29th, observed as 0.0 Hunabku, in order to maintain the 52-year cycles. The leap day in the Maya calendars, the ancestral Maya count, never stops on a Gregorian leap day. In other words, the Maya long count, the Maya Dzulkin calendar, and the Maya Hab calendar always keeps on counting. Thus, the ancestral Maya real time is not connected to the Gregorian calendar, whereas the 13 moons is dependent on the Gregorian leap day of 29 February in order to manifest the adjustment of 00 Hunabku. Hunabku, the prayer of the seven galactic directions, celebrating the power of timelessness. 0.0 Hunabku, the mantra, the code for today is, I coordinate in order to potentiate. Enumerating totality, I seal the cosmos of unity. With the galactic tone of emptiness, I am guided by my own power doubled. I am the activator of all galactic portals. Enter me. In Lakek. So let us know, beloved beings of light, in the comments below what you're experiencing on this great quantum leap day of the new earth year. Let us know what you're feeling, what you're seeing, what you're experiencing, your visions, your dreams, what you're seeing shining through the veils on this most auspicious day out of time. And these daily transmissions are archived. The link will be in the description below this video. And we have over 1,000 archived articles on our website, primedisclosure.com. Now, if you're new to this channel, be sure to subscribe. Click the subscribe button below and the little bell next to subscribe to get notifications on future uploads. So have a beautiful and blessed day out of time, New Earth time, as we're transitioning into the passageway, the gateways of the March activation portals. Keep walking your path with heart. Beloved being of light, I love you all. Namaste.